Hi, I'm Mr. Schwanebeck. I'm the art teacher at Horizon Elementary. Today, I had a student who was upset in art, mostly because he couldn't get his artwork to look real. And that's a problem that I sometimes experience too. Maybe you have felt that way. It can be frustrating when you have an idea or a vision of what you want something to look like, and you can't make it happen on paper. What I wanted to share with him, and I'll share with you, is that not all artworks have to or need to look realistic. There is a whole branch of art called abstract art that doesn't look real or natural at all. Abstract art happens when an artist chooses to arrange the lines or colors or shapes in a different way, different from how it really looks in the real world. Yellena James is an artist who works this way with abstract art. She's a Bosnian-born artist who works in America. Her organic shapes are inspired by the sea. Organic means that the shapes that she uses look like they came from nature. She creates abstract art by changing the size or the color of the plants that she observes. She might make plants look much bigger than they normally would or smaller. She might change the color to an unnatural color that doesn't really happen in nature. Artists often change the patterns and the shapes and the arrangement of their work because they feel like it makes a better artwork.
Another technique she uses is called overlap. You probably remember overlap from our last project. Overlap is when an object covers up part of another object. Do you notice some places where she has one plant overlapping another plant?
We're going to create an organic sea picture inspired by the work of Yellena James and the organic shapes of the sea.
Now it's time to get out your sketchbook. Turn to a blank page and create two or more thumbnail sketches. A thumbnail sketch is just a small sketch that an artist makes before they begin the big final artwork. Feel free to look at the sea plant templates that I included in Seesaw, but I have a challenge for you. Try to use three or more organic shapes, three or more patterns, and use overlapping in each of your thumbnails.
When you're finished, take a look at the thumbnail sketches you created. You'll need to decide which one you're going to choose to develop into your final artwork. Looking at mine, I think I really like this one. Once you decide, I want you to write a sentence or two that explains why you chose it. Now, I chose mine because I like the extra overlap and the way it fills the space.
When you're all done, be sure to post your picture to Seesaw. Find the activity. I know this one says space lesson, but be sure that you choose the Seascape one. Press the add response, choose your name. I chose sample student, but you'll pick your name. Then choose photo. Line up your camera so that it includes your picture, then snap a photo with one of these green shutter buttons. When you're ready, click the green check mark. That will upload it and post it to Seesaw so that your teacher can see it.